Hello and welcome. This is Shireen Qureshi and you're watching It's Tomorrow News. 20 dead, millions displaced amid Cyclone Bulbul, 50 flood warnings in England. 20 people have died and more than 2 million others have spent a night huddled in storm shelters after Cyclone Bulbul hit the coast of India and Bangladesh with fierce gales and torrential rain, officials said on Sunday. The cyclone packed winds of up to 120 km per hour when it hit late on Saturday, forcing the closure of ports and airports in both the countries. 10 people were killed in India's West Bengal state, the Press Trust of India reported, including two after uprooted trees fell on their homes and others being struck by falling branches in Kolkata. Two others died in nearby Odisha state, PTI reported. In Bangladesh, 8 people were killed, 5 by falling trees, and at least 20 people were injured. 5 others were missing after a fishing trawler sank in bad weather on the Meghna River near the southern island of Bola, district administrator said. The cyclone also damaged some nearly 4,000 mostly mud and tin-built houses, disaster management secretary said. In coastal Khulna, the worst hit district in Bangladesh, trees were ripped from the ground, blocking roads and hampering access to the area. Some low-lying parts of the district were flooded, disaster management minister said. Bulbul hit the coast at the Sundarbans, the world's largest mangrove forest, which straddles Bangladesh and India and is home to endangered species, including Bengal tigers and Irrawaddy dolphins. The mangrove shielded the coast from storm's full impact. Some 2.1 million people across Bangladesh were relocated to cyclone shelters. Troops were sent to coastal districts while tens of thousands of volunteers went door to door and used loudspeakers to urge people to evacuate their villages. About 1,500 tourists were stranded on St. Martin's Island off southeastern Bangladesh after boat services were cancelled. In India, nearly 1,20,000 people who were evacuated started to return home as the cyclone weakened, authorities said. The storm has left a trail of destruction as it's crossed the coastline of West Bengal, the state's urban development minister said. In Odisha, the crops in coastal regions were extensively damaged by the cyclone. Bangladesh's low-lying coast, home to 30 million people, and India's east are regularly battered by cyclones. While the frequency and intensity of the storms have increased, partly due to the climate change and the death tolls have come down because of faster evacuations and the building of thousands of coastal shelters. Meanwhile, 5 severe warnings deemed a threat to life remained on South Yorkshire's River Don, while flooding in that area likely to continue until Wednesday. Towns and cities across Yorkshire and the Midlands have faced disruption and, in some cases, emergency evacuations. Former High Sheriff of Derbyshire has swept to her death by the flooded River Derwent near Matlock. In addition to the severe warnings the Environment Agency earlier issued, a further 43 warnings, meaning flooding is expected, and 103 alerts. It said water levels were still very high on stretches of the River Don and expected flooding in that area until midweek. A military helicopter was used on Sunday evening to drop sandbags at the Bentley Inns by the river. According to Salvation Army, some people had been rescued from their homes by boat since the early hours of Saturday morning, but others remained in the properties. South Yorkshire Fire and Rescue crews are on hand to evacuate any Fish Lake residents who may be stuck in their homes, and we would urge everybody to take advantage of this. Homes in Stanford, Thorpe in Ballin and Trumfleet have also been evacuated. South Yorkshire Police said it had extra officers out on patrol to protect the evacuated areas and support those affected by the floods. Some residents were angry and frustrated at the Doncaster Council, claiming it had not provided sandbags early enough to prevent properties from flooding, the station reported. One of the most severely hit areas has been Bentley in Doncaster, where flooding affected many homes 12 years ago. That's all for now. For more news updates, stay tuned with us. It's Tomorrow News. Shireen Qureshi. For more weather updates like these, please subscribe our channel.